Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for joining our today's live session. My name is Eva May. I am CGTN Travelogue host. And next to me is Xiuwu, who is the organizer of today's expo that we will be walking through with you guys and experience everything that evolves around this beautiful traditional clothing, which is known as Hanfu. Exactly. Yes. How are you today?
Good. Oh, 很好，谢谢。 欢迎来到第一届汉服博览会。谢谢，谢谢。好的，那我们就一起
explore the actual thing. So let's go and see. All right, let's go. That's like a very grand entrance, as you can see. Can't get any more majestic than that. And here we are. So let's walk in to the first point, which is pretty much the neon lights that we can see here. And what is it exactly? Is there a special meaning behind this kind of setup here?
这个是个主入口的一个打卡地，是希望来第一次汉服博览会的观众们对我们整个主题性有一个认知。然后呢，我们是一个比较古风前卫的一个方式。然后呢，希望大家来第一次汉服博览会的游客或者是这个参与者，能够对我们传统文化和现代往前走的一个汉服的产业，它大概的一个整体的一个表述方式，然后能够拍照留念。
Okay, I see. So it's like really incorporates, as you can see, neon lights here, but it has very traditional elements that kind of have been modernized here. And obviously, I think these gentlemen here are the best example to showcase what this place is best optimized for, and it is for a photo opportunity. I think in social media times these days, it's a good opportunity to take a first photograph before you explore the actual expo. So shall we continue and just like see the other further stations? Let's see. Hello.
Hello.
All right. So it's really a huge expo, and I am not exactly sure how many certain stations we have here, but I've heard it's around 100.
有不同的板块，我们这一块。
Okay, so there are like very different stations that not only expose perhaps like the clothing, but you also have a lot of craftsmanship work that will be shown to the visitors who are coming to this expo. And I think this is also perhaps a good first stop to tell our audience and showcase them this traditional clothing. I know that there are a lot of like kind of characteristic elements that are very famous for Hanfu. So for example, you have a very flat design. What are the other specifics?
咱们汉服设计这块主要它讲究的是天人合一和阴阳交叠，所以说你看这个交里游刃这一块，它就是一个阴阳交叠的一个概念。Okay,
so not only do you have usually like a flat shape, but it's also reflecting kind of like the Chinese culture when it comes to the balance of yin and yang. So I know that there are, I think, 8, if I'm not mistaken, elements that really characterize Hanfu clothing. And not only, as I've mentioned before, it is about like the flat design, but you also have a very centralized design, which represents yin and yang culture in China, as well as a very centralized design from the fourth front and the back row. I've also heard that sometimes you need to like tie around certain ribbons on the right side only and not on the left side because it also reflects cultural elements. What about that then, for example?
这一块它是在不同的style里头，它其实是有不同的一个打的方式。你看，像我这个马面裙，它就是会系在中间。 然后在有一些制式里头，它是会靠右一些。
Okay, what about like I think like Hanfu? I haven't seen any Hanfu that really includes, as we know from Western culture, for example, dresses that actually include like buttons or zippers. It's usually always a ribbon or a belt, is it right? And like how does Hanfu like it consists of several pieces of clothing? So for example, what I'm wearing now, it might look like one dress. But tell you, I've worn Hanfu for the very first time, and I did not know before that it consists of various pieces of clothing. Now, let's go and check out a few other stations and see what's going on here. Is there anything that you would
recommend? 这边是我们的主要的特装区，它的这个是我们的一个核心板块，就是我们整个博览会里面有将近300家参展商，但是最中间的这些是一些比较有特色的，他们把我们的文化内容以 汉服的方式做了一些呈现，所以说咱们可以先到这儿来看一下。
Okay, awesome. So we're going to visit the first stall, which is pretty much the brand of the clothing of this beautiful Hanfu dress that I'm wearing today. And it really incorporates a lot of Chinese cultural elements. So can you explain maybe perhaps on one of these dresses what the cultural elements that you have incorporated in these designs are?
这边我们其实是在这里头有不同的元素的汇入，你看像那种花鸟啊什么的、
yes.
这种很可爱的图案，然后把它放在我们整个汉服上，然后呢让它对购买者它的一个表现性非常的明显，然后呢也非常非常非常好看这样。
Yeah, so you can always see like repetitive patterns, for example, that are connected to nature, which is also representing Chinese philosophy, because Hanfu also stands as the unity between heaven and men. And for example, you can see this beautiful, delicate embroidery of flowers, birds, a little sweet bunny here that you have incorporated in each of those designs. All right, perfect. Shall we go and stroll around the other stops and stalls?So fascinating. I wish you guys could see. You should come to this expo. Is it the first expo here of Hanfu?
This is 第一届
Okay, so
it's
the first Hanfu expo here in Xiuwu County, here in Henan Province, for those who do not know where we exactly are right now. So let's take a look. Where shall we take a stop next?
儿童汉服。
儿童汉服。
对，儿童汉服。
Okay, so...We have some beautiful Hanfu clothing for kids as well.
对，本来是有很多的，因为来的游客太多，然后给买的只剩这两件了。对，咱们这个重辉汉唐的品牌，它专门有儿童汉服，小华小夏，然后有男孩和女孩，但是我现在只看到有女孩的了。
Okay, so usually on this clothing stand, you used to have like more of these clothes, but because she said during the expo, it was a...very demanded and they pretty much sold out each item already, but you can see you have also beautiful Hanfu clothing for kids.
就像 Eva 说的，它是层层叠叠，中国的衣服它其实是有内外。
Yes.
对，所以它有内外，从里到外，然后它的一个阴阳交叠。
Exactly, so you can see here again, as mentioned before, Hanfu clothing consists of several pieces and parts and layers, and you have a top as well as a bottom, and they have a very own philosophy on how to like wear it. So for example, you have like a Y design, which also symbolizes the balance of yin and yang, as mentioned previously. And you have here, you can see a piece of clothing with a belt tied as a ribbon, and yeah, beautiful. Okay.So let's see, what do we have next here? Clothing stand, maybe?
这些就是成人的衣服了。
And some few visitors who want to join. Okay, so pretty much like each design is...
这个是宋朝的。
Okay,
宋代的。
From Song Dynasty. Beautiful.How do you know? So like each dynasty, I think the clothing has also like evolved in like its design, perhaps, right?
对，他们每个都有自己的一个制式。
Okay.
然后还是就是主要是汉代、唐代、宋代、明代。
Okay, so obviously fashion evolves at a certain time than afterwards. And you have, thank you, let's go up to the next station. Different designs for each dynasty. Okay, what is that? Oh, that like looks also very interesting from its design.
对，这个问一下重回的品牌的，
哎你好，
咱们这个是唐
唐
的，对
唐的 ，OK， 都是从唐代的，
啊对
，OK，So you can see some slight differences， 谢谢啊 ，You can see some slight differences in each piece of Hanfu clothing， which is very very interesting。As bespoke， it's my first time that I'm wearing these beautiful dresses， so yeah。Let's move a little bit apart from fashion wear and see what the expo also offers the visitors other than clothing. And it's also some little souvenirs, I think.
Yeah, 这个是一个国风生活方式的一个、
okay.
国风生活方式的一个，就像您说的 souvenir shop.
Yeah.
然后它是把咱们很多汉服啊文化的东西，然后以小的配饰的方式来给大家一些比较轻一点的选择。就除了一套衣服之外，比如说一些小的配饰啊，然后一些。纪念 面瓶，包括喝水的杯子，然后其他方方面面的，它就是已经算是一个国风生活方式的一个品牌，叫汉服演艺。
Okay, this is also one of the Hanfu brands that also incorporates a lot of these items that reflect Hanfu tradition and culture. So you have, aside from like little jewelry, you have plastic souvenir pieces, like some mugs, as well as I think like t-shirts, and what else can I see here? Just so many items that are being offered. So yeah, beautiful. Love it. All right, let's see where we can bring you next. Let's go this way. Okay.Listen to the expert. Sorry guys, by the way, I do not want to be rude while you might be asking yourself why I'm holding my hand with a phone is because I am awaiting some comments from our users here. So if you have a comment about anything that evolves around Hanfu, please feel free to comment and we will do our best to answer the comments of you guys. Okay, this is Henan Museum stand.
Yes, 是的。
What does it have to offer?
非常棒的考古盲盒，就是咱们河南博物院的考古盲盒是，哎，咱考古盲盒有吗？啊？
哦
，Oh no， 又 sold out again。对对对，这个是咱们省博物院通过博物院里头的文物，然后做出来的一些衍生品、文创产品。然后呢，它有一个爆款，就是咱们的考古盲盒，就是它的把小的这种小的方方面面的小的这个考古的物件放在泥土里头、
oh.
然后你不知道你拿到这个盒子里头是什么东西、
surprise、
然后你会有 surprise
right,
盲盒、right. 所以说呢你可以把它拿一个小的我们的小的洛阳铲给它自己给它挖出来然后说 wow surprise
Okay, so that's amazing. I wish they would still have one, but it's good for you guys that it got sold out because it's so popular. But what they usually have is an item that is very popular and it sells you an experience. It sells you the experience of, I would say, an archaeologist at home where you can actually have a small piece of rock. Is it true? Like a stone or like a little rock?
Yeah, a piece of rock
or, yeah. And that you would just like hammer and you don't know what exactly awaits you, but like an archaeologist, you would hammer and hammer and hammer until an object appears, which is obviously connotated to Chinese culture, but you can see here, this would be one of the examplesyeah, but unfortunately for us, they got
sold out.
No worries.
It's always sold out online too.
Really? Yeah. So it's very, very popular and in high demand.Let's see. What else can we do? Do we miss out anything here or can we like continue somewhere else? Which one? Okay. Let us see. There are so many different stalls.This one here?
对啊、这个是唐宫文创和十三余的一个结合店。
Okay.
这个唐宫文创呢也是一个文创品牌。然后呢十三余的话呢是一个汉服品牌。所以他们是你看这儿有衣服然后呢也有一些方方面面各式各样的一些文创产品。它也是跟用文化为作为底蕴然后呢用日用品的方式来给大家传递一些比较美好的信息。
Okay, then shall we like take a look inside? So basically what they do here is also, I think it's pretty similar to the other stroll as well that incorporates this traditional Chinese culture and combines it with modern designs these days and produces it in, for example...
本来盲盒长得也跟它很像，我以为我在这儿找到盲盒了。
I think we're both like missing that one piece of item that we saw before because we really want to experience the archaeological
rice wine.
Okay.
就是方方面面的生活用品，然后呢，都是以传统文化的方式给它表述出来。
Okay, so you have like some traditional goodies here as well, such as the rice wine, and I think that's like some little snack that we have there. And okay, let's check out the other stalls because it's a live broadcast right so we're doing everything very spontaneous and trying to find like some bits and pieces where we can like show you guys what this expo actually has to offer let's see so we got the clothing we got the archaeological experience we have some beautiful souvenirs that are combined with Chinese culture I have a question I have to ask why exactly Xiuwu County as the center for Hanfu? Is there a specific reason for that?
Because Xiuwu is in Henan, Henan is our中华文化的文明发源地，然后呢，Xiuwu呢又是一个千年古县。 然后他自己也是以美学策源地，就是县域美学策源地，所以说他所有的东西都是为他来以汉服做第一届汉服博览会有很大的一个帮助。Okay,
so it's pretty much the what's going on here? Pretty much, 这个也是吗？我觉得。
大家对整个就是说汉服它表现出来的一些美感和它方方面面的都特别喜欢，除了穿衣服之外，喜欢打卡，喜欢拍照，喜欢为这个来做传播，而且不管年龄，不管是孩子还是老人，他不是说只是针对一个年龄层次，我看着还挺开心的。Yes.
So let's get here as well and like show you around what's going on here. So Xiuwu County is pretty much the origin of Chinese civilization. And for example, because it has also a lot of like famous brands here that really try to modernize Hanfu tradition, it's also very popular among not only the young generations but also the older generations. And you have brands that are also trying to incorporate some modern elements into their traditional Hanfu clothing. So you can see it, for example, this brand is very distinct from itself from the others through its colors, a little bit of the pattern designs, and it's very feminine. And I would also say, like, the colors are very subtle
most of the time. Yes,
absolutely. Spring has arrived when you see this beautiful piece of the stroll. Okay, let's go and see where else we can go to. This direction, I can see there are also other photo opportunities as well. They did really a lot of effort. They put a lot of effort into the decoration. Oh my gosh, these are real fish?
Yes, these are real fish.
Okay, okay. Wow.
荷花，所以它要配鱼。
Oh, okay.
鱼系荷叶间。
And this is also a station, sorry, a stall where they sell not only another brand of Hanfu clothing, but you also have an opportunity to pose for photos, I think so. Okay.
对，每一个品牌其实它都有它自己的一个内容的一个呈现，比如它不管是它本身品牌的理念，或者它这一季的一个想法，它都会把它呈现出来。像这一季很明显的，这个就是它自己的一个呈现，然后这个就是一个互动拍照打卡的一个装置，你们可以上去坐一下。Nice.
Looks very authentic. It's just like I'll try to like be the funny person and then do a little bit of a move here. So it's very nice because I've also seen that the elements of the Hanfu dresses, they are compared to Western fashion wear, I think quite different in the sense of not only the cutting, but they don't really emphasize on the body curves of a person, rather on the movement of a person, because it's very floating and you have the feeling like it goes with the movement of the wind, which also represents kind of unrestrained elegance, I shall say. Yeah. So let's see what else we have here. Okay. 故宫文化, forbidden cities culture. This is amazing. So 故宫文化, it's very popular, right? Or why is it?
因为是这样的，这故宫大家都很熟悉，但这个是故宫第一次用它自己的文物，然后把文物做成了一个服装，所以说它是用了三件的作品，然后呢，对，但是是第一次一个用现代服装的方式，以汉服的方式来表现文物这个文化承载的东西，所以说这个还就是除了故宫本身的知名度之外，这是它第一次上新。
Okay, so it kind of Forbidden City is generally also like very, very popular among like Western countries and Western culture. And like the elements that it has in there, they tried to also incorporate in certain designs. So you could actually say that the Forbidden City here has served as a sort of inspiration for their traditional Hanfu clothing. And for example, I can see in this picture here, this is a rock formation with calligraphy. And then next to the person, next to the rock formation, you have a model wearing, is this like also like a beautiful...
It's a robe,
exactly.
Beautiful.
That's like when creativity comes in handy. If you have a rock formation with calligraphy on it, to see it as an inspiration for modern Hanfu clothing. It's beautiful, absolutely beautiful. And here you also have some little pieces of souvenirs again, I guess. Yeah. Beautiful. Very, very nice. Okay. Let's continue our stroll around the expo. I'm seeing if I'm getting any kind of... Ooh, okay, I'm seeing there are a few comments here. Sorry, let's just stroll through some other comments. When did Hanfu got popular in China? As far as I know, in the recent years only, but I think you can elaborate on this a little bit more.
是这样的，汉服呢，它其实是 年轻人对于传统文化的喜爱，然后自己架构出来的一些，其实是现代服饰，但是它是基于传统对文传统文化的喜爱，是03年的时候开始第一个，就是所谓的汉服复兴运动，大家就是It's Renaissance too，然后开始了2003年，然后一直到现在十来年了，但是真的加速的话就是最近几年。
Okay, in recent years it got more and more population, especially among the young people. And I think it's also from, I've talked to a few visitors here at the expo as well, who have told me that they are very happy about this trend of this kind of like, yeah, modern trend these days of people wearing Hanfu, because they feel like they can reconnect with their cultural identity and also promote this beautiful ancient culture to the rest of the world. Let's see, there are also another questions of these Hanfu are very attractive with small details like ribbons with embroidery, small sizes, unexpected pattern design. It really looks modern. Yes, I agree. Which dynasty Hanfu do I like the most? That's a very good question. I think from what I have seen so far, it's probably either Shang Dynasty, which is, I think, the dynasty where it has actually evolved from, as well as Tang Dynasty, because they have like these beautiful, beautiful embroidery elements that also incorporate, yeah, just like look visually very, very appealing. Yes, exactly.
你穿的这一套是魏晋风，所以说很飘逸。
Does add to the certain elegance to it.
Like a win.
Yes. Let's see. There are some other questions. Again, is Hanfu appropriate to wear to work?
是的，就是说在汉服里面现在有常服这个概念，就是说它其实是非常有实用性的，就日常可以穿的服装。像打个比方，像您上穿的这身，其实上班一点问题都没有，平时日常通勤。
Really? Okay, so and also like from them, what I can like see from the stage, they're also wearing these beautiful dresses. Maybe we can like ask the camera men to also have a look here. One of the fashion shows.
这个是一些咱们河南省的学生他们自己的表演。
Okay.
就年轻人非常非常喜欢自己的传统文化，也很爱汉服。And
did they come up with the choreography themselves?
是的，都是他们学校学生自己编出来的，都是学生。Wow.
Okay. So these performers that you have just seen on stage are students who came up with their own choreography to also present the Hanfu clothing on the catwalk. I am going to speak a little bit more into the microphone because I think it's quite loud here at the expo, but it's beautiful. It's really absolutely mesmerizing. Shall we have another stroll there? Okay. Alright, let's see what's up next. So yeah, thank you so much for the comments that you have sent in so far. And to touch on the last question again, with the Hanfu clothing. So you said this would be for me appropriate now to wear to work. I see, so I'm going to tell my colleagues at work, then do not look at me in a surprise way when I come and show up, perhaps in this dress, the next time I'm at office with my Travelogue team. Okay,
yeah. 这个是咱们郑州歌舞剧院非常非常优秀的这么一个节目，弹弓夜宴是他们今年特别火出圈的。然后呢，他们除了做舞蹈的编排啊，整个是一个这个 song and dance theater 之外，他们还是对咱们中国文化有很多方方面面的一些表述，就是像书法呀，然后像一些画啊这样。
Yes, so this is also, you can see like Chinese calligraphy. You also, inside of the Chinese calligraphy, you have beautiful, beautiful traditional Chinese paintings. And it all, thank you so much, 谢谢. I unfortunately wish I was able to read, but what does it say on this piece of paper, for example? Is this like traditional? It's traditional Chinese.
对，是的，怀邦清唱正常空，这是七言是吗？对，老先生，您讲一讲。对，这首是我的原创诗，说的是咱们这个秀武的场里，非物质文化遗产有个传承的这个老怀邦，这是七言四。
So this incorporates also pretty much a lot of Xiuwu County's tradition, right? 而且老先生是用七言的，就是说中国古诗里头，它比如说有五言，就是每一行五个字，然后呢，像《古诗十九首》里面，《涉江采芙蓉》《兰泽多芳草》，这个就是传统的五言。然后这个七言很多是唐诗，它会用七言，就更加复杂。不好意思，就是七言，七言的那个意思是。七言就是一句话是七个字。Oh,
okay,
sorry, because that's like where language barrier comes through and it's real, guys. But okay, so qian means that you have like seven characters, Chinese characters, instead of the usual five?
Five.
Okay, okay, all right. So also like a part of traditional Xiuwu. And then...
刚才错过了，咱们刚路过那个，对，不可思议的修武，咱们刚才过了一个那个墙上写着我们现在所在地第一届博览会修武，就是说它是一个不可思议的地方。
之前我也跟伊万稍微提了一下，对，exactly. So why the question was initially that we have also mentioned before, why exactly Xiuwu County as the location for this year's Hanfu Expo, but as I've been told, it's because of not only is Henan Province as a province the origin of Chinese civilization, but Xiuwu has also, especially in recent years, really experienced a huge increase in demand of Hanfu wares because it pretty much is also like nowadays known as the hub for Hanfu. And that being said, because we're speaking about like recent years and how this tradition has like evolved, I can also see for the future, a very bright future for Hanfu.
Yes.
What is this and where are we standing right now?
这个是第一届的汉服趋势展区, as you say, Hanfu Trend 2022. 然后呢，这个是第一次把时尚趋势的方法论用到了汉服这个朝阳行业里面。 然后呢，整个趋势发布呢，它是分成了把现有的汉服的喜爱者分成了四个 category， 四个不同的群体。然后呢，我可以稍微的讲一讲啊，这个应该是第二个板块，它是一个就是叫创想者，然后呢是比较。 跟古代神话有很多关系的，就是说你看它的色彩是偏这种粉粉嫩嫩，就是桃色一点的。然后呢，这个趋势的人呢，他是比较喜欢一些就是古代的神话呀，它的色彩呢比较柔和。然后呢，你看一下，他会用很多就是跟动物。 相关的元素，然后呢表示一些灵性灵气，然后也是跟这个神话有关的，比较仙女的这么一个category， 这么一个群体吧。对，然后呢它其实分成四个，第一个和第二个是相对来说比较古典的，然后那边的话是第一个是传承，相对来说比较保守，非常的保守，然后它的色调是淡紫色，然后这个呢比较仙女镜，但是呢比较淡雅一些，是桃红色。然后呢那边两个呢就更加表现主义一些了、
okay.
就是对它更加表现主义一些呢，它会有一些实用性啊、功能性啊、防水防雨的元素在里头，就是一些汉服爱好者他们也喜欢到户外，虽然穿着这样的衣服万一下雨了呢，所以它在布料的选择上会有一些功能性融入进去。
That is so cool. Sorry for interrupting you. I'm just going to explain to our foreign friends here briefly, long story short, then what exactly this station is here about. So basically, it is a forecast of the upcoming fashion trends in Hanfu clothing for next year. Not only are they showcasing various patterns as well as textiles, but also certain motifs that are very popular and in demand for the upcoming new year. And yeah, and as Xiaozuo has explained before as well, you can see the colors here are very different from each other because it also has to like suit a certain personality's taste, obviously an individual taste. But you also have like textiles, for example, for women when they are maybe like living in a city that is, you know, raining more often, that they would have like actual textiles that are, how do I say this in English, like 反映就是反成就是像您刚才说的那个下雨的时候呢
for more practical use.
Thank you, for more practical use, exactly. But that's
like
beautiful.
Waterproof,
yeah,
more
waterproof.
Outdoor.
Thank you. It's like our cameraman almost tripped. Probably because he's so excited about this. But that's beautiful. So we can like see here also some showcasing of like the upcoming, I think like,colors, right?
对对对，这个色调是偏这个暗一点的，跟刚才的仙女的不太一样。
Yes.
对，这个稍微偏暗，偏更功能性，但是更现代一些。你看，它会用到一些会就是比较亮一点的元素。然后呢，它的比如说实用性啊，它是把它的一个现代性和实用性表现出来了。像这两个群体呢，就是除了这个之外，那边那个乐享，它其实都是偏现代、偏表现主义一些的。
Okay.
对对对，那边的话就更加 bling， 更加的表达自己，就更丰富的多了。
Okay, so this part of the section kind of like includes more of the basic and neutral patterns as well as colors, whereas you have the different section on the other sides, which has more sparkling bling fashion wear to offer. All right, and then we have here another beautiful station that I do have to say like reminds me, I couldn't really say that it's like traditional Chinese design because it resembles a lot of also like a bit of like Korean,
right?
Okay, so this is the street of craftsmanship, basically. 基本上都是也是手工的，对吧？
对，全都是手工的。像这个第一家，你看看。
Okay. Have like some handmade craft works.
绒花。
It's called 绒花. So these things are all called 绒花. Okay, so these are 绒花. Why is it called 绒花? What does it mean?
因为它是用这个是丝绒。蚕丝做的，对。
Oh, okay. So you have this like delicate little piece of art, I shall say.
对，用一些原材料做出非常美的这种配饰。然后您不然稍微讲一下这个咱们绒花的一个制作。
绒花是由蚕丝制作而成，经历了十几道工序，由生丝变为熟丝，经过染色、拴绒、打尖儿。和那个打尖儿以及最后的传花，经大体上四个大组合的部分，里面再细分很多很多小的那个步骤，将它组合成一定的花的形状。然后绒花现在主要就是也是咱们国家的一个非物质文化遗产，它 目前来说，随着汉服的复兴，现在学会制作绒花技术的人也越来越多，所以就是绒花的款式也从原来的很传统的一些传统款式，也逐渐的像现在的一些很灵动的一些款式在变化，在发展。
是小老虎。
对，这是一个小老虎、小鸟，这些都是一些很传统的，小的时候我们赶庙会的一些款式。然后像这些的话，就是我们一些仿文物的一些款式，算比较传统。
谢谢，
然后一些新的一些。
谢谢给您那个解释，我就告诉我们的外国的朋友们，大概叫什么，告诉他们一下。So basically, these are also like this little like hand craftsmanship is also incorporating a lot of classic Chinese elements, natural, but that have to do a lot with nature. And so, for example, you can see lions here as well as fish, flowers, and ducks. Like these are, again, I've also.Mentioned it at the beginning of our live stream, repetitive motifs that you can not only see here in the jewelry or an accessory of Hanfu clothing, but also in the Hanfu clothing itself. And now we're going to have a look on how this is exactly made. 要这样子做的话，像要做一个这样子的一个这个小绒花的，要大概要多长时间能做完成？
大概需要三天。
3天? Okay, so it takes around like 3 days to actually complete a little accessory like this. Again, it's all handmade. Let me see if there are some other questions as well. Okay, so right now what is being produced and made by this lovely woman is a little flower. So you're going to stack up all the pieces together. I bet it just looks way easier than it actually is.
Very cute, right?
Yeah, it's very, very cute. So how do people learn this art? Is there any certain institution that you could visit if someone wants to follow this tradition? Or is it being passed on usually from generation to generation?
它是传统工艺，所以说呢，真的是匠人，就是一代一代传承下来的。
Okay.
而且现在从古代到现在，经过这么多年了，就是一直能传下来。但是之前做的人是真的是越来越少了，就像他说的一样。但是随着汉服的整个复兴以来，然后因为整个绒花它其实跟整个，它是配饰，然后搭配着汉服，然后慢慢的来回到这个来做绒花的人又越来越多了。
That's beautiful because it is indeed a craftsmanship that is being passed on from generation to generation, and as this a lovely lady said before, because it has been unfortunately a craftsmanship that has been dying out through the trend.And the upcoming of trend of reviving Hanfu fashion, obviously the accessories that come with Hanfu clothing are also getting kind of reborn, and it is a craftsmanship that a lot of young people now are eager to learn more and more themselves. And it's really a beautiful way to keep a tradition alive. Let's see if there are some other questions in the comments. And there indeed is. For example, hi Kenny, how does Hanfu feel? And is there any accessory that make a good combination?
其实配饰这块跟汉服它是密切相关的，就是说它不同的不同的 style, 不同的这个制式，它有它自己应该的配的一些东西，而且呢，它也可以随着咱们自己的心情的搭配。然后就像说刚才说的，为什么绒花这个行业现在回来的人越来越多了，就是因为它是一个配饰跟着服装走的这么一个概念，就是让传统的工艺又得到了一些复兴。
Yes, exactly, because that really touches on what we have said before and have showcased before with the 绒花 jewelry. With the Hanfu fashion, it also comes a lot of accessories that you can combine it with, obviously depending on what you feel like and how you are in a mood, and what kind of mood you are in. You have 绒花 accessories, but you also have beautiful handcrafted pins, hairpins, and other small tiny bits that you could do. Yeah? 刺绣. All right, we have embroidery. Embroidery piece of fans, I can see. These are all handmade fans, right? Oh, wow. So you're gonna see live how they're trying to sell something. Okay, so they're talking about how they want to like, so how these, can I say this? So these are the fans that you will actually sew some embroidery pattern on, as you can see here in the background, and it's also really delicate handcraft. I've always seen in ancient Chinese dramas from certain dynasties of like these beautiful ancient ladies with the fans, so it's all handmade as well, obviously.
刺绣肯定全部都是手工刺绣上去的，这个小扇子呢，它是既有一定的装饰性，又有一定的功能性，所以，但是他们咱们这儿其实是一个非常好的一个刺绣的，哎，麻烦您稍微的讲一讲咱们这个刺绣的一个，就是大概的一个绣一个小扇子大概花多长时间，一些工艺上的，是这样，就是在这个板上要做的吗？
是，这个就比如现在修这个吧，现在是一个精修，也就是现在是一个完工的作品，我们现在精修一下，就需要现场秀技整理给大家看一下，行吗？谢谢麻烦您了。That's
going to be very exciting because this lovely lady just said that she's going to show us how a fan with this traditional embroideries actually being produced, and tell you what, I would have not thought that it would like look like this. It looks very complex and complicated.
这个大概要绣像你现在绣的这个东西，大概要多长时间才能完成？这个绣图长是宽是，就是50×1.3米的一个尺寸。这个绣图大致绣成精细度的话，大概就是40天。40天，对。
Okay, wow. So for any kind of like pattern of this size, you would need around 40 days to complete.
那这个价钱应该就是也是比较高一些了吧？这个价钱是5000多。5000多.
Okay, so it's I was asking about like the value of a piece of art like this, and it comes to around 5000 yuan.
另外跟你讲一下，因为我现在是一个精修用所用的线，蚕丝线就是我们一根线里面要分出来十，就是十匹的其中一丝，两丝线，也就是现在所看到的可能要比我们的头发丝还要细一些。哇，天呀！
Okay, so the thread that they are using here are even like thinner as human hair sometimes, which is amazing because you can see that there is like also a huge difference between each thread. So thread doesn't mean thread automatically. There is a difference. And the one that she's using here is one of the more delicate ones. And yeah, let's
just
take a look.
现在就是一个精修，也就是两丝线。那您这个也就是要从下面绣，还是？我们是两只手绣，上下不分左右，也就是说一个针要递过去，另外一个手要从下边接针。 也就是说，等于说我们下边这个手是盲绣的，就是不用看的，全凭感觉。就太难说了。Okay,
so the embroidery technique that they here use is, I'm not sure if I translated now correctly, so please forgive me if it's wrong, but double thread, so you are actually, there is like a very specific technique to it that you can also like pull the thread like from down and up at the same time in order to get this kind of pattern. And she said that if you do it like more often, obviously, thanks to muscle memory, it will go with the flow and start at some point to become automatic. And I'm sorry, I'm just seeing, don't want to be rude, I'm just like trying to see if there are other questions coming in.
Oh.
看一下，真的好细啊！ So you can see how fine the thread here is. It really is thinner than my hair. And I thought I already have very thin hair. I mean, obviously this is not my real one. 好嘞。
这个是从小学的吗？
我十几岁，一般学刺绣、学绣花的话，大致上就是在16岁时候开始学。
哇，都是跟你母亲学的吗？还是
拜师学艺？
拜师学艺，
对。
Wow. Okay. So, 谢谢您啊，谢谢您。So let's move on because time is quite tight.
衣服的话，
好了。She learned embroidery, by the way, at the age of 16 already, which she said is pretty common. And now let's see. This is not embroidery this time. This is a what is this? A tailor? Tailor. Hello. 你好，你好。Oh, let's get see if we can get some tailored 汉服。
对，是汉服。自己手工做的，
手工做的，
对，接来料定制，就是你有喜欢的布料，感觉自己这个布料穿到身上好看，你把料子寄给我，尺寸告诉我，做完成衣之后我给你寄过去。像后面这两个都是我自己做的，
正好。So it's like a very customized opportunity, like a customized opportunity. I'm sorry, I'm a little bit nervous apparently. No, but you can go to this lovely lady and tell her what kind of textile you want to have, what kind of patterns and motifs you want to have, and she is going to do the magic and customize your requested hanfu for you. 好，那我就下次知道我要穿汉服的时候，我应该要去哪儿。
没问题，没问题，好的。
谢谢啊，谢谢您，谢谢。Beautiful.So, you got like tailored opportunities as well, but we do not want to leave the men alone. You can see you also have hanfu wear for gentlemen. This reminds me of any kind of ancient movie of some Chinese warriors with these beautiful, what is this, like silver plates. Wow, it's super delicate.Super delicate. Obviously, everything is handmade as well. I really would want to know how long it would take in order to produce a uniform like that, but I am sure it's going to take at least a few weeks. And let's see, is anyone inside? No, unfortunately, nobody is inside. But if nobody is here to watch that I'm doing something forbidden, nobody could tell, right?Except for just being on live broadcast of national television. But anyways, okay, so you can see somehow these have already been sewn together. So it really consists of these individual pieces of silver plates. Oh my gosh. And then you would use a thick thread like this. And you got like the holes here. And you will just like try to combine them all together.Kind of like looks like the pattern of a fish skin, right?
对，也可以说是龙鳞吧，就是说有这种鳞，
dragon.
鱼鳞，
yes.
龙鳞。
Yes, okay. So, very nice representation of a Chinese and Western mind. I think of fish, she thinks of dragon. All right. Wow. 好的。行。Let's see what awaits us even more so.
这一家它除了汉服之外，它还有一些配印的礼仪这一块的，所以它衣服是一个载体，承载的还是文化，所以这块我们可以稍微看一下。
Oh, okay. So this also, this place especially incorporates a lot of Chinese culture into their clothing. 哎，您好，您好。请您跟我们就大概说一下，你们这里是也是汉服，但是区别跟别的地方是什么？
我们主要是接定制的，这里边放的一些呢，都是一些那个布料是普通的布料，就是一些不同的款式，让大家供大家选择，主要是接定制的。
Okay, so like the textiles that you have here are rather simple, but he can like also give you a huge range of like textiles to choose from, like a rather simple material, but with the combinations of certain other pieces of clothing, you can get something obviously also very customized for your own personal taste as well as liking. 非常感谢您，谢谢。
中文是
不是
好，长得又漂亮。
真的是外国人。Got a very curious visitor.
She can't tell.
That's very sweet, though.
我在想你怎么能讲这么好的中文。
Oh, that's very sweet. Yeah, I guess I don't look very have Chinese to most people.
你看着就像外国人，但他不能相信为什么一个外国小美女能够讲这么流利的中文。
Thank you. It's fun. It's like the fun part of live stream, right? What is this?
但是对，这个是做妆造的地方。就像汉服的话，它会除了衣服之外，哎，咱们这儿来呀，你来了，对对。
小姐姐就在附近。
啊，把小姐姐叫回来吧。
对，我给小姐
姐。对，她没回来之前，我先稍微讲一讲。这个所谓的妆造呢，就是the complete makeup for 汉服，对。它是这样的，它除了头发，它会有不同朝代的这种发型啊什么的，所以说它整体你看这个就是什么发包，然后你会在自己的头发上，然后再做出一些造型，然后配着这个头发，然后再做妆容，然后再配衣服，是一个 complete 这种 makeover.
Okay, understand. So you can see here several pieces of fake. Is this fake hair though, or yes, is it real? Okay, yes. Fake hair. But Hanfu fashion is including a lot of not only several pieces of clothing, but you also have to keep in mind that the hairdo is a significant part of the overall Hanfu appearance, as well as the makeup. Now, the hair that I got done today, you can see I also got like this like small piece inside, and tell you what, it does take quite a while in order to get a hair dye done. And unless like in other cultures, for example, I think the most important is to always like start with like the hair goes with the clothing, and the clothing and the hair go with the makeup, so everything is kind of intertwined with each other.
The hair goes with this.
And the hair, exactly, the hair goes with this, which is also one of these significant hair accessories that you could also see, I think, on this side, yeah, that I have here today as well.
对，因为你这个造型其实是非常魏晋风的话，它是偏飘逸，所以说相对来说是比较简单的。比如说一个妆造一个小时，把这个上面的立起来，然后呢，它没有太多的一个装饰。但如果是一个唐代的，它唐代就是非常丰富的这种春天的感觉，色彩丰富，所以它要做个造型的话，可能得两个小时，因为它在这个头发上就会配入很多的这种发饰来了。然后除此之外的，跟衣服整体它一个华丽感相关。
So the fashion also in the different dynasties not only like differentiate from each other, but also the hairstyle. So for example, the one that I'm wearing today is rather simple. However, you have, for example, hairstyles from the Tang Dynasty that are much, much more complicated and complex, and it really takes 2 hours in order to finish an actual hairdo. Plus, they come with a lot of different hair accessories. And speaking of accessories, we have another stall with beautiful, I think also partly or if not even all of them are handmade, jewelry and accessories not only the hair, but also necklaces. So, wow.
对，这很多，应该这些都是发饰，然后这些是配饰，是吧？
对。
哎呀，这个是干嘛用啊？
哇，这个好漂亮。
这些都是禅花，这些都是，就可以自己做一些造型啊，就是把线都缠上去。
这些都是手工的吗？
对，全部都是纯手工的。
Okay, so it's all handmade. It's all handmade, and you have like all these different creations with also different.
Yeah. 古代它这个丝绸的，它能把。他做出方方面面的，用丝来做衣服，然后把它给你拆细了做刺绣、做发饰，它都是跟丝。
Okay, so it's all here. As I'm going to show our cameraman, you have these hair pins and hair accessories made out of silk, and silk.Obviously is a huge part of Chinese culture and always incorporated somehow at one point or the other in Chinese fashion or jewelry, as you can see here, and lots of other elements. Okay. Yes, you have also another material, which are kind of like pieces of like small pieces of glass. Sewn together as beautiful, beautiful flower pieces that also add to the feminine touch whenever you put it onto your hairdo. Very, very nice. Tell you what, I'm probably gonna go shopping after this live stream. 好的，谢谢你啊。
拜拜。
Wow, okay.And I think we have another stop here that also looks very interesting. everything is very interesting. What is this? Hi, 你好. Fabrics. Yes. I can see that. What kind of fabric is this?
咱们这边是做衣服的还是卖布料的？
做衣服的。
哦，这个就是我说平面剪裁，就是对汉服跟咱们就是西式的剪裁不一样，就是它不是立体，它是平面剪裁的。
Oh, okay, so Hanfu, one of like the Hanfu characteristics is that it has a very flat design. It's flat and it's very simple, as you can like see here. But if you wear it to the body, because they're also like most of the times like.Larger than the body size of a person.
对，它会比较宽松。
Exactly. So it's like more, you know, more like bigger in size, but it's also part of the culture and the tradition. And it's, I love it.
不同的布料，您这边是那就是定制衣服是吗
？Okay.
那您自己也是做汉服设计和剪裁？
对，做剪裁。
So you can also have the opportunity to get a customized Hanfu at this stall here.
因为这些布料是让人特别看着开心的，各式各样的。
Yeah. 我能不能看一下吗？谢谢。这个布料是叫什么布料？
欧根纱。
Ogunsha. Okay, so this is a very specific material. I think that you can also see it in the camera. It has this shiny surface and it feels rather, yeah, rough. I'm not sure what the English term for that is.
它这个主要还是因为它的色彩 bling bling,
yeah.
比较有先进的，就刚才咱们经过趋势那一块的第二个 category, 它比较跟神话、跟仙女、喜欢仙女的这群人群有关，他们可能就会比较喜欢用这样的布料来做的汉服，这样或者还要把这个融进去。
对对对对，这个也是比较摩登的。
对，你看它这个就更加表现主义一些，这个相对来说这个色彩就更加的传统性要强一些。
Yeah, so if you use this kind of like material for Hanfu, you would probably move more into the modernized version of Hanfu clothing. But a lot of females and young women love this kind of stuff because obviously, as said before correctly, you can add a little bit of a bling bling to it. Whereas this textile is more of the traditional textile, but doesn't mean that it is less beautiful.
好的，谢谢您哦。
OK, 拜拜。Let's go out. All right. Okay, and then think. So, what is your favorite Hanfu dressing from which dynasty would you say?
我是在唐代和宋代之间比较纠结。对，因为唐朝的话，它像代表春天，是色彩非常丰富的。但是宋朝它的美学是像秋天。就它比较轻，它比较就说水落石出，它是雨过天青色，非常的简单，但是高级。所以这两个之间，我还区分不出来，两个都喜欢。
Okay, so she prefers the Hanfu from Tang as well as from Song Dynasty because she said that it kind of reflects and represents not only in its patterns but also in its colors the seasons, which of spring in Tang, I think, and autumn in Song Dynasty.And so, okay, so you love spring and autumn season, I can tell. When's your birthday, actually?
July.
July, okay, July. So you're a summer kid, I like that. And so if you would say, what would you like hope or what is your prediction for the future? Do you think this trend of Hanfu is going to evolve more and more and will it really be integrated as a part of...Daily life here?
我相信肯定是的。我觉得汉服的复兴也是一个中国年轻人对自己文化的一个自信。然后呢，这个趋势会越来越壮大。所以说呢，将来汉服肯定是能够破圈的。
That's a very bright future for Hanfu. So thank you very much for today's live broadcast. Thank you for joining us as well. We hope you enjoyed it. And yeah, see you next time. Bye.
谢谢你
哦。
谢谢你
哦。好，拜拜。